I've been working on making a super cool prototype part. This is a piece of clear acrylic that's overmolded with flexible polyurethane. This is a lid, and I'm going to show you how I make this prototype part.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
This video is sponsored by my friends and proud supporters of the channel, BJB Enterprises. They provide quality, casting, and molding products. They're a leading manufacturer and supplier of thermoset polyurethane, epoxy, and silicone systems worldwide. BJB, taking the mystery out of materials. So, to overmold these polyurethane parts over the piece of acrylic, I'm going to use some 3D printed molds. It's going to be a four-part PLA 3D printed mold. I'm printing it on my Ultimaker, and I'm dissolving the PVA support material here. So if you have never used a printer with dual print heads, the second print head prints with a water-soluble PVA material. This allows you to get amazing overhangs on parts and then just dissolve the material away. Stuff that may be difficult or would normally cause not such nice parts if you printed your supports in the same material. So here's my four parts, and I'm waxing them up really good. And I just do that to fill in maybe a little bit of the texture and as additional mold release. And I wipe that down, and now we're spraying on some Stoner urethane mold release spray. And I spray this on the PVA to allow the urethane to set up and then, of course, release. Now I use my laser to cut 1 millimeter thick acrylic material. This is the window or the top of the lid. You'll see there's these corners have holes in them, and then the jagged frame. This allows the polyurethane to bond and stay connected to the acrylic.
All right, when I'm picking out material for casting, I love to consult my BJB Mega Material Chart. It's fantastic for selecting the right material based on the project. They have Shore A, flexible polyurethanes listed here on the left, Shore D, semi-rigid polyurethanes, water clear polyurethanes, and then their adhesives and brushable urethanes here. Rigid polyurethanes are over here. Silicone casting rubber for making molds, expandable polyurethane foams, and then epoxies. All right, let's see how these charts work. Let's take a look at the rigid polyurethane. This shows you basically the shore hardness of the materials, the working time, the demold time, shrinkage, and a bunch of other things, and then most importantly, the color potentially. So you can choose a material based on the hardness that you need, the work time that you need for your project, and whatever color you need your material in so that you can tint it or leave it natural raw color. Super handy. And then you can go to your material selection keychain, and you can actually preview and hold and touch that material in your hands, see if it's right.
So the piece of material I'm flexing here is the Shore A 80 hardness polyurethane that we're gonna actually cast with. We're gonna use the BJB CF80AM. It's a 50 to 100 ratio, very easy to mix. Working time of about 14 to 16 minutes. I really love that working time. It gives me plenty of time. And if you're just making one or two parts, that's a dream time to have to work and mix up your material. Take your time, degas it. It works really well. So I'm mixing up here with 15 milliliters of material, 50 grams of one and 100 grams of the other. I'm quickly throwing it into the vacuum tank to give it an initial degas. And after that's over, we're gonna take it out and we're gonna load it into the syringe that I'm gonna use to inject it with into the part. So we'll load it into the syringe and then we'll put it back into the tank. And of course, the working time here of the 10 to 14 minutes is fantastic for this. So you have plenty of time. It'd be pretty hard to mess up with this kind of working time. So I'm degassing, doing the final degas right in the syringe. And then we're going to inject into one of the holes. And you'll see it come out the other side here in just a second. Yep. And then we'll let that harden. And then we can demold it. All right, we'll just trim up the part and we'll take a look at what we get from this initial part. So even though this looks like a total disaster, this is actually a success. So what we want is we want this material to stick to this acrylic, and it sticks really well over here. The acrylic slid inside the mold, and that's easy to fix. We'll use some PVA and we'll get that back, and we'll do another one. But this is actually pretty successful, even though it looks like a total disaster. I'll just use a little bit of white glue, some PVA, and this will help me seal a few places in the mold, but it'll also allow me to basically glue the clear acrylic in place and keep it from moving. So I place the PVA on the mold, not on the lens, so I don't scratch it. Here I stop and then I do the other half and I snap the mold together. And that, once that's dry, that will lock the clear acrylic in place and prevent it from moving around during the injection process. And so we'll let this cure. We'll see how that turns out. We'll remove the clamps off the mold. Even though this mold is sort of locking, some extra clamping force is good. Remove these globs from the top, and then we'll take this apart. And I can see that PVA has really helped, also just preventing the urethane from going everywhere. We'll gently pry off the side pieces here, and of course this part has a massive undercut. There's a 1 millimeter ring, you can see, that locks that piece in, but it's a flexible urethane part, so it comes right off the mold, and it's molded really nice. I'm going to make another one. I need to make a minimum of two for this project, and so I'm just showing you how I make the other one, basically following the same process. I can tell that first part is going to come out, and so I want another one here. We inject another one, same process. Here's the part, another nice part. You can actually see the white glue still on the acrylic, but of course it's water soluble. So super easy to clean all this up and all the mold release. We're just going to put that in some water with a little bit of soap or detergent, and that will remove that glue and all the release agent and allow me to now just clean up the part. You know, all the little bit of extra material that seeped just underneath the acrylic. Basically flash on the inside. There's a little bit of flash on the outside. I can trim that off with an X-Acto blade here as well. So some cleanup is of course required. It's not a big deal. Prototype part, it's not a production part, but this is a pretty nice part. I use a little bit of sandpaper. This is 400 grit sandpaper, and for any flash. And you can see there's a small air bubble that happened on the one side. If you wanted to fix that, you just pop it right back on the mold, put the mold together with a little bit of polyurethane, and you could easily fill that. I probably will. This is the part. Very, very pleased with how it came out for a prototype part. It works great. Stay tuned, and at some point in the future, you'll get to see the entire project and how this goes together and what this is for. I just can't reveal that right now, but that's how I overmold a prototype part. Very, very pleased. Hope you liked the video. If you enjoyed it, make sure you give a thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button and notifications so you can be notified of any future videos that I have. You can check out some of the other videos that I have here, and you can follow me on social media as well, on Instagram or on Twitter. I often post there of stuff that I'm working on before it makes it to YouTube and get kind of a little sneak peek sometimes. Rock on.
Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.